everyone. Thanks for being here. I'm Dong Sung, a professor at UC Berkeley. Today, I'm really excited to be here to talk about a really important topic, AI and security, that I think every AI and machine learning practitioners should know about. As we all know, AI and deep learning is making great advancements. For example, AlphaGo is winning world champion, and deep learning is empowering everyday products. While we're enjoying the exponential growth of AI and deep learning in its capability and applications, in another landscape, unfortunately, we're suffering from another type of growth, where we see that attacks are increasing in scale and sophistication. For example, in the recent Mirai bot attack, attackers have compromised over 400,000 IoT devices, including security cameras and baby monitors, over 160 countries, and caused one of the largest distributed denial of service attacks in history. And also, we continue to see really large-scale data breach attacks, where in each incident, attackers have stolen sensitive information about hundreds of millions of users. Also, we continue to see that attacks are entering new landscape, including power grid as well as banking systems. All this tells us that when we are deploying and building machine learning, it's really important for us to consider the presence of attackers for a number of reasons. First, history has shown that attacker always follows the footsteps of new technologies and sometimes even leads it. And also this time, the stake is even higher with AI. As AI controls more and more of the systems, attackers will have higher and higher incentives to attack them. And also, as AI becomes more and more capable, the consequence of misuse by attackers will also become more and more severe. When we talk about machine learning in the presence of attackers, there are at least two types of issues that we need to consider. First, we need to consider how attackers may attack AI. Attackers can attack AI in several different ways. So first, attackers can try to compromise the integrity of the AI and the learning system by causing the AI and the learning system to produce the wrong or unintended results, and even to produce intended results designed by the attacker in a targeted attack. And also, the second, attackers may compromise the confidentiality of the learning system to try to learn sensitive information about individuals. To address these issues, we need to design better security in the learning system. Secondly, the attacker may try to misuse AI. Attackers can try to misuse AI to attack other systems by finding vulnerabilities in other systems and devising new attacks. To address these issues, we need to develop stronger security in other systems. So first, let's look at how attackers may attack AI and look at the first aspect, how attackers may try to attack the integrity of the AI system and why this is really important. So first, let's look at the scenario of self-driving cars. In the self-driving cars, as the car drives around, it needs to observe the environment, for example, to recognize traffic signs and to make the correct decisions. So here are some photos, one of a clean stop sign, and another is a photo of a real-world stop sign in Berkeley. So here, as you can see, even though with the stop sign, there may be some marks, actually, in the real-world photo, humans can recognize these stop signs correctly with no problems. And also, in this case, the machine learning system can also recognize these stop signs correctly. But however, what if an attacker actually tried to create some malicious modifications or perturbations to the traffic sign in a way that it actually tries to maliciously mislead the learning system to misclassify? So these are what we call adversary examples. These are perturbations that are specifically crafted by attackers to mislead the learning system. And in this case, when we feed these adversary examples to the computer vision systems, they cause the machine learning systems to misclassify these traffic signs into speed limit signs. Even though, as you can see, to humans can recognize these traffic signs correctly with no problems. In our work, we have been studying the phenomenon of adversary examples. In this case study, we demonstrate that adversary examples, not only that they can be real and feasible in the physical world, and also they can remain effective even under different viewing distances, conditions, and so on. And here, we are going to see a quick video. The video has two frames side by side. The video will show that as a car is driving towards the traffic sign at the end of the road, at the bottom of the video, it's going to show the prediction label given by the computer vision system. One frame has the original traffic sign, and the other frame has the adversary example, the modified traffic sign. And what the video, from the video you can see, for the adversary example, as a car drives towards the traffic sign, the computer vision system continues to give the wrong prediction. So this example demonstrates why we really need to pay attention to how to protect the integrity of the learning system against attacks. And this is the attack happens at inference time, and also attacker can also cause the learning system to learn the wrong model at training time by injecting poisoned training points into the training sets. Overall, these are examples of what we call adversary machine learning, which is about machine learning in the presence of attackers. Overall, adversary machine learning is particularly important for security critical systems. So this is the first aspect, how attackers can try to compromise the integrity of the learning system. So next, let's look at how attackers can try to compromise the confidentiality of the learning system by trying to learn sensitive information about the training data. As we all know, data is a new oil. However, a lot of this valuable data is also very sensitive. And this is today how today's current framework for data analytics and machine learning. In today's setting, data is being collected, and then the analyst will write the analytics and machine learning programs, and these programs will then run on the computation infrastructure to produce the final results. However, there are several types of threats that these current frameworks will encounter. So first, the analytics and machine learning program itself actually may not be trusted, because the analyst may be an insider attack, or the analyst's account may have been compromised. Secondly, the computation infrastructure itself may also be not trusted. For example, attackers may have compromised the computation infrastructure. And finally, the computation results itself may leak sensitive information as well, because the computation results actually has been computed from the sensitive inputs in the first place. To address these three different types of threats, we need to develop different types of techniques. So in our work, we have developed different types of techniques to address each individual one of these threats. So first, to address the threats of sensitive computation outputs, leaking sensitive information, we develop new techniques and tools for differential privacy. To address the challenge of untrusted program, we develop new techniques with the program rewriting and verification to ensure that for an untrusted program, we can automatically rewrite it in a way to enforce the desired and security and privacy policies. To address the challenge of untrusted infrastructure, we leverage new secure computation techniques. So first, let's look at the challenge of computation outputs leaking sensitive information about the inputs. One question one may ask is, deep neural networks, they have very high capacity. What do they remember? For example, do they actually remember the training data? And if this is true, can attackers actually extract secrets in the training data by simply just querying these learned models? In our recent work, in collaboration with the Google researchers, we have set out to explore these questions. In one of our case studies, we demonstrated that here we have a learning task that tried to learn a language model from an email data set, the Enron email data set, which contains actual people's social security numbers and credit card numbers. In our work, we demonstrated that attackers can devise new attacks such that by just querying the learned language model, the attacker can extract the social security numbers and credit card numbers that were embedded in the original training set. And hence, this is an example demonstrating that as we do machine learning, it's really important for us to pay attention to how to protect users' security and privacy. And also, we have developed a new measure of exposure to measure this type of phenomena, which has been successfully used in Google Smart Compose to try to mitigate privacy risks. And the good news is that for such a problem, we actually have a good solution, which is to train a differentially private machine learning algorithm. So model. In this case, by training a differentially private machine learning model, we can significantly reduce the risk of leaking user-sensitive information from the trained model. To make such techniques real and be able to use in the practical real world, we actually have developed new techniques and tools to make it really easy to deploy differential privacy in the real world. And some of our work has been deployed at Uber for GDPR compliance. In addition to these two threats that I have talked about, it's also very important for us to address the challenge of untrusted computation infrastructure. And in this case, we can leverage new techniques in secure computation. The goal of secure computation is to protect the computation process from leaking sensitive information about the inputs and compute, even when the computation infrastructure may be compromised. And there are different types of solutions that we can leverage, including crypto-based solutions as well as hardware-based approaches. The crypto-based solutions, the challenge is the performance overhead is really high, often with orders of magnitude performance overheads than native computation. With hardware-based solutions, utilizing new secure hardware capabilities, such as secure enclaves, it can achieve close to native performance overheads and provide very strong security and privacy guarantees. And in fact, such capabilities as secure enclave can serve as a cornerstone security primitive for building new security applications that couldn't be built otherwise for the same practical performance. All the hardware manufacturers have recognized the importance of building secure hardware. However, there are still many challenges in how to build truly trustworthy secure enclave as a cornerstone security primitive. In particular, in order to achieve the transparency that's needed to ensure truly high assurance for secure hardware, it's really important for us to have an open source design. Towards this goal, we actually have a new effort in collaboration between MIT and Berkeley called Keystone, aiming at developing an open source secure enclave, and currently on top of the open source risk architecture, RISC-V. To put this together, we can build a platform for secure and privacy-preserving shared learning, where users' data is encrypted at rest, and the data analyst does not need to change its workflow. It can just write its data analytics and machine learning pipeline. And then we can use programming writing in this case to rewrite the untrusted data analysis and machine pipeline to ensure the desired security and privacy policies. And the rewritten program will be run on the computation infrastructure with secure computation technologies deployed to finally produce differentially private outputs that will ensure the security and privacy of users' data. In this case, the data owner does not need to trust the pipeline or the infrastructure and to ensure the security and privacy protection of users' data. So far, I've talked about the first aspect, how attackers may attack AI to try to compromise the integrity or the confidentiality of the learning system. On the other hand, it's also really important for us to ensure that these learning capabilities are not being misused by attackers. For example, as we have seen in the recent case of Cambridge Analytica, AI can be misused for large-scale automated targeted manipulation. And also, one really important thing to keep in mind is that the leaked data actually has very long-term consequences. Once it's leaked, the consequences may come down years afterwards. And this leads to an open question, a bigger question, about self-sovereign privacy. Today, users have lost control of their valuable data, and the data is being used for learning and influencing users' behavior, sometimes made for the wrong purposes. And users don't know what their data is used for, they don't get paid for the data, and they can't take the data back. How can we address this issue? So we are exploring a new direction, how we can leverage some of the capabilities in blockchain, such as decentralization and enforcement, to try to build a new platform towards the democratization of AI to have a blockchain of intelligent smart contracts. To put this together, so today we have essentially look at the different important problems that any AI and machine learning practitioners need to pay attention to when you build and deploy machine learning and AI. We need to prevent attackers from compromising AI systems for integrity and confidentiality. We need to prevent attackers from being able to misuse AI. And there are many open challenges in the intersection of AI and security. How can we detect when a learning system has been fooled and compromised? How can we build privacy-preserving learning systems? And how can we democratize AI? I strongly believe that security will be one of the biggest challenges in deploying AI, and it requires a community effort. Let's tackle the big challenges together. Thank you.